Hello friends, today I will talk about role of employer branding in human resources management. So there are three, four important characteristics which are there as we can see in the today's talent market, and which can help, and employer branding can help us to address some of those challenges. So I will list out some of these challenges. The first one is that there is an acute shortage of talent. As per the recent report by Manpower Employment Outlook Survey 2018, it says that globally about 45% recruiters face challenges in getting talent. Also, what is more significant about this report is that India is one of the most difficult country to attract talent. So there are group of countries which are classified as most difficult regions for attracting talent, and India is one of those. The second important, which is a consequence of the first one, is that since there is a talent shortage, there is a war for talent scenario. As you can see, now talent is considered to be more candidate driven rather than the employer driven. So another data I would like to cite here is one of the report which was published by Harvard Business Publishing, which says that in 2015, more than 90% of the respondents felt that current talent market is candidate driven rather than employer driven, which was the case earlier in 2011. So that's another important characteristics. Another important challenge that currently we see in the talent market is diverse segments in the talent market. As you can see that now you have Gen X, Gen Y, and also the baby boomers also there. So all three, four segments are there in the workplaces, and what is challenging here is that they have diverse expectations from the employers. So the meeting the diverse expectation is a significant challenge. And one of the report by Deloitte Millennial Survey says that nowadays, since millennials are there in the workplace, their expectations are different than the other segments, and more importantly, the career models are changing significantly. So these millennials look for flexible career models rather than more structured career which were there earlier. So that's another challenge. And finally, the meaning of employment experience has changed significantly. So now you do not see 9-to-5 job, you do not see the structured careers, okay, no lifetime employment, rather it's a kind of more a concept of employment experience. So there are significant challenges for HR managers to address some of these important important issues which are there, as I pointed out just now. So how do we address this? So one of the strategy which I talk in my courses is employer branding, which we can use for addressing these talent issues. So what is employer branding? Employer branding is a marketing tool where we apply marketing and particularly the branding principle for making company as a great places to work or a best companies to work for. So basically, we are trying to position a company in the prospective candidates' mind that the company is a great places to work, or is a really good where you can go and join. So this concept employer branding makes use of three, four important concepts of marketing. One is marketing research, the second is customer value proposition. So similarly, in the employer branding, we have employee value proposition. Third is your communication, okay, marketing communication. So here we have to communicate employee value proposition. What is important about employer branding, I'll just recollect this, that the core of employer branding is employee value proposition, which is primarily a three-step procedure. So similar to marketing, in employer branding, where we do identifying expectation of job seekers and target audience. So it could be the job seekers or it could be the existing employees. The first step of employee value proposition is to identify the expectation of the target audience, which is very similar to what we do in marketing research, to identify expectation of the consumers. The second important step here is to divide the target audience of different segments, so that we can customize our offering, employment offerings, to the different segments in a targeted manner. So it's very similar, as I was talking about marketing, that companies design different types of products for catering to the needs of different segments. So similarly here, based on the expectation that we got to know through the first step, we have to segment our target audience in different segments. And once that we know the how many segments are there in the labor market, in the talent market, then we design our employee value proposition. And employee value proposition is nothing but the kind of benefit, kind of rewards that company offers to the current and potential employees while working for that firm. So it could be monetary, it could be non-monetary, and there are different employment benefit which can be there. So what is important here is to design customized employee value propositions for every segment. And the final step is to communicate that employee value proposition to various segments in a targeted manner. So again, we use marketing principle. How do we design effective communication for communicating employee value proposition to our target audience? So in summary, what we try to do in employer branding, we try to make use of marketing principles and more specifically branding principles to attract talent and to retain the existing talent so that we can gain significant benefit by having them in the firm. So this is a core of this is a summary of employer branding discipline which I teach in TISS. So thank you very much.